Good afternoon. My name is Rod Lakes, Faculty of Engineering Physics and Biomedical Engineering, and also the Center for Rheology Research. I'd like to talk a bit today about presentation of data in both graphs and in tables. And so you have your the website available here entitled Graph Quality. So this is really a rogues gallery of graphs. These are real graphs from real reports from real students. And I'd like to use them as representations of correct and incorrect methods of graphical presentation. The first one labeled A1 is velocity versus time during a movement of a human body in a biomechanics context. And you notice velocity has no units, and velocity should have units. And the time has no units either, and as you know, time should have units. So in this case, we're not communicating what we should, because without knowing the units, we really don't know a whole lot about either the velocity or the time. Moreover, the time scale is 1:11:21, and this was generated by software. Really, it would make more sense to have 0, 10, and 20. An even more egregious example of the numerical scale is graph A1.1, and you have numbers that look like 7, 13, 19, 25, 31. And you might think, well, this is part of the Da Vinci Code or some other sneaky way of communicating mysterious information. And actually, this was generated artificially by software. There's nothing at all special about these numbers. And by having them horizontal, what that means is you want to kink your neck like this, and it might cause a biomechanical injury to your neck. To create a kink like that looking at the numbers. So both the sequence and the fact that they are tilted horizontally is rather hostile to the user. And so if your software gives you that kind of a graph, please take some additional time to make it look better. This one here, A2, graph A2, has on the vertical scale notation 4.00E, -05. This originally came from the Fortran computer language, which goes way, way back. In 1965, to communicate with a computer, you would create punch cards, one punch card per Fortran statement. There was no graphical interface. You were not able to communicate in a sensible way. The computer wouldn't understand Greek prefixes. So, to communicate with the computer in 1965, that's how it was done, but it's rather later than that, and here we are trying to communicate with human beings. So this is a rather archaic and user-hostile way of communicating. Where did this come from? Well, it came from certain spreadsheet software, which may be quite good for business reports, but which does not excel at scientific or engineering applications. So please change the scale, make it scientific notation, that is 10 to the minus 3, 10 to the minus 4, or use Greek prefixes such as milli, micro, mega, giga. These things are rather familiar. Okay, the next one is A3, and this shows a lot of zeros on the vertical scale, and this is great if you're writing for a popular newspaper that say, hey, our numbers are really, really small, but for science and engineering audiences, you want to rather be more friendly and less hostile to the reader. So get rid of the zeros, please, and put in Greek prefixes like milli, micro, or scientific notation. On the horizontal scale, you've got a lot of zeros, and if you're tired at the end of the day, you don't want to read all those zeros. It's very tiring. It gives you a sense of nausea and distress. So again, scientific notation would be appreciated. And it says log time, but if that were really true, you'd be talking 10 to the 10th, 10 to the 1,000th That's not really what's meant. It's already log scale, so just say time in seconds. Okay, in this case, again, we have ludicrous numbers of zero. This is A4 example here. And curiously, even though we're working in base 10, there are tick marks showing repeats on the log scale every 100. Again, the software writers have made a mistake, but the user of the software, that is you and I, should not go along with that error. Please fix. So I took these data, which are presented in a painful way, and I scanned them and replotted them in the next graph. So we're going from A4 to just after A4. They are indeed supposed to overlap, so I'm using now scientific notation here for the horizontal scale, and so things are easier to read. And plus, we have big numbers in time, so I show, well, here's one day over here, and here's one year. So the big numbers correspond to long times. I help the reader by gluing that in. The software will not do that for you. This one is even worse, A5. So the log, or the time scale on the horizontal goes 0, 1, 10, but it's a log scale. You can't have 0 on a log scale. Somewhere the software writers messed up on their middle school mathematics, and it's in your software, and so you need to, if you use that software, compensate for these shortcomings. So, and then the next one, I said, well, let me try using spreadsheet software and draw a graph, just see how painful it is. And you get the Fortran notation as a default. You get gray, which is unacceptable either in technical reports or publication reports. And plus, it's painful and depressing. Gray is not a happy color. And so this is the default. So I took the same original data set and then used graphics software, and one of my favorites is Collidograph, which is available on a variety of platforms, including the ones on the CAE system. So if you're using CAE computers, you can use Collidograph. And so here we get a much more user-friendly and easy-to-read graph. So let me go down, in the interest of time, to graph A9, which I want to go to A11. All the scale marks are so fine that here I've magnified them with a millimeter scale, and this is very close to the resolution limit of the human eye. So since a human being is reading this, and a human being is just as tired as you are, please don't give them this kind of painful choice. Please redraw the graph. My final series of comments deal with significant figures. And let's say, as an example, I just clicked at the link on the bottom of the web page on graphs, significant figures. And so the number of significant figures that you present should be related to the number of actual digits that you have confidence in. And just as an example, I measure the diameter of a cup of coffee with a millimeter scale ruler, and I get some number between 80 and 81 millimeters. That's two significant figures. If I had 100, I might say three significant figures. Your software will quite often give you 10 digits. For calculation purposes, that's wonderful, but for presentation purposes, the human being has to read all those digits, and it's a tiring task. So unless you're measuring the speed of light at the NIST laboratory in Colorado to extremely high precision, or unless you're involved in, say, frequency standards for radio transmitters, you probably don't need so many significant figures. So either with a calculator or your computer software, you can reduce the number of significant digits to the number that are really supported by the experiment. And even if you're doing numerical work, all the results that you use as input data ultimately come from observation. So it's very easy to make it easy for the reader and also truthful for representing just how well you know a certain number. So thank you for taking the time to consider this. Have a good day, and I'll sign off for now.